Okay, when did this change? It's not going to be on anchor. I'm going to stay on the boat until it's secure, because that's what I was promised by you guys.
All I'm saying is, all we've been told is, after these guys are done, we issue you a direction, you have to go to hotel quarantine.
Okay, well, I'm not leaving my boat unsecured. And so if you need to arrest me right now, we can do that.
Yeah, I'll let it float away. I'll let it float away. I'll let it float away. Float away. Float away. Yeah, I'll let it float away.
Jack, you been up since 4?
Yeah.
And I got 81 emails. 81.
Okay, when did this change? And I don't mind if they want to take my family and go ahead and send them to quarantine, and then I move the boat up to the boat works, or leave one of me and one crew on the boat, one of my sons on the boat. All right, so a lot of things changed last night. Queensland and Australian Border Force have changed the rules. They're now, they did say it once, you can take your boat and secure it. They made us provide security, a berth, book a berth at a marina where we would take our boat after they cleared us in, and then we go from that marina straight to quarantine. Now they're making us just leave our boat on anchor, and who knows what happens to our boat. We have to make arrangements for somebody to come get it and take it to that marina, and hopefully we can get them on our insurance or boat insurance, all these kind of things. They're also only giving you 1 hour to get off your boat and leave it just out in the middle of nowhere.
Everyone say bye, Archer. See you in 2 weeks.
Bye, Archer.
Thanks, everyone.
Things that should be done following an ocean passage and when leaving the boat for 2 weeks. Remove all food from fridge and freezer.
Gather and discard all trash.
Remove and properly stow
AC cocks and flush holding tanks.
Empty and clean bilges.
Remove and stow
frost and clean freezer.
Wrap dock line.
Attain level of
simple.
Everything is sound.
Drink half a cup.
Are we still on our way in there? We got an hour?
Yeah.
Are we going, or are you just stalling?
I'm just going to slow. I want this little storm to pass over.
Yeah.
As soon as we arrived in Australia, we learned that the rules had changed since we set sail from Fiji 10 days ago. With a sudden spike in COVID-19 cases in the neighboring states of New South Wales and Victoria, Queensland had tightened security measures and imposed new regulations. We were now expected to drop anchor in a mooring field, disembark the boat immediately, and take a taxi directly to the quarantine hotel. But first, we had to enter the quarantine dock and get checked in by Australia Border Force.
One of you like to take the line?
No, we don't have mine.
You're going to have to get close. They're not allowed to take the line.
I don't know if he can hop off the boat. Ask.
Is it all right if I hop off?
I got to tie the boat up, guys. Hello.
Hello.
Come, come in, have a seat.
Thank you. Oh, you're trying to run
here. We should quarantine. We're fully. When we left Fiji, they told us what we had to do here.
Yeah.
And we've complied 100% with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And now they've changed it where we can't secure, the whole reason for coming here was to secure our boat from cyclones.
Yeah, absolutely.
Leaving it out here on a short hook and not being able to hire a captain, I can't hire anybody and get them on insurance. It's holidays in America, it's time zone differences. There's no way I could get somebody that approved.
Yeah.
And so I'm not gonna leave it out there. They won't let me. So the rule was when we left Fiji, as Hell said, you've got to prove to us you have a berth at Boat Works or wherever that marina is going to be.
Yep.
We did. We booked it. It's there waiting for us.
Yep.
And then you will move your boat from there to Boat Works. People are closed for the holiday weekend. It's just not going to happen.
Yeah.
So I cannot leave this boat.
So you didn't have anyone organized to move it for you then, is that what you're saying?
We didn't have to have anybody. I'm the captain. They said I could do that. That's what the policy was going to be.
Well, I'll see with Queensland Health, but the information I've got is if the boat
can't be anchored out there.
We'll have to find somewhere for it to anchor.
Well, it's not going to be on anchor. I'm going to stay on the boat until it's secure, because that's what I was promised by you guys.
Well, that wasn't promised by me.
By your government.
Yeah.
And you're wearing the uniform.
So if whatever Queensland Health, I'll have to organise with them, but as far as we've been told...
Just honour the word. Honour the word.
All I'm saying is, all we've been told is, after these guys are done, we issue you a direction, you have to go to hotel quarantine.
Okay, well, I'm not leaving my boat unsecured. And so if you need to arrest me right now, we can do that.
We don't want to, obviously, but anything to escalate to that.
So. But I'm just saying I'm not leaving the boat, so you're going to have to make sure you press that to your superiors. I'll leave it.
Well, Keith does get a little riled up sometimes, but the Border Force guys and the Maritime Police were actually very understanding and didn't take anyone to jail. They immediately started to help us figure out a solution to this predicament we were all in.
The whole point to come to Australia, safe haven, secure the boat. It's the whole purpose of coming, secure the boat.
It was a long morning, but these guys were very patient and worked hard to get us permission to move the boat. After 4.5 hours of discussions and emails to Queensland health officials, we finally got approval.
We just got a phone call saying it's been approved, so we're just waiting for the writing.
Well, I better get things, guys. Oh. Damn.
Yeah! What's that about? I thought you might be excited about it.
I wet myself right there.
While Keith and Jack take the boat to the marina, me and the kids head on to the quarantine hotel.
All right, see you in a bit. Go into the hotel for 14 days of quarantine, and Keith and Jack are moving the boat over to the dock, and we're gonna get settled. And the good thing is I brought our math book, Finn. Aren't you happy about that?
Oh.
Yay! There's a lot of them.
It's COVID, Finn.
COVID, Finn? You're anti-COVID, Finn.
While on passage, we thought if we kept a record of our temperature every day, it might help reduce the amount of our quarantine time once we arrived in Australia, maybe even allowing them to count the 10 days of passage.
97.7.
98.2.
I'm 97.9.
Hi, my name's Finn.
All right, my temperature is 98.1.
It's 97.8. December 23rd.
Okay, 97.9.
98.6.
98.1.
98.4.
Unfortunately, it didn't help. We still had to quarantine for the full 14 days.
Sounds dreadful.
It really is kind of a pain, but somebody's got to do it.
Dad, what are you doing?
Going down rabbit holes.
He's social media-ing.
You know, I justify that while we're in quarantine because we have nothing else to do.
I have basal cell carcinoma.
Basal cell.
The carcinoma.
Send a picture to a dermatologist. And that's what the dermatologist said he thinks. He had
I don't know, but...
He's concerned.
I'm concerned.
He's going to die. You need to go fund me.
Okay. I got to order now. I got to order some diet food.
And then I drink my Diet Cokes
all right, so
while I'm eating Krispy Kreme donuts. Jack, is that trash or is that lunch?
It's lunch, Jack. It actually looks really good.
Really?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Look at that. That looks good.
Here, could you get those? Yeah.
Save my order for later.
Okay, yeah.
I need a hamburger.
I'm good.
That doesn't look bad.
What do you know? They had a Coke.
Pretty good looking burger.
Yeah, I want that Coke.
Did you surprise?
Are there fries with it? No?
No.
Chips?
Oh, there's salads. That's good.
Ooh, who wants a salad with a hamburger?
That sounds pretty American right there. American.
Through their first example. It's really easy, you just have to remember what to do. The negative exponent, write 3 to the negative 2.
3 to the negative 2.
Okay, that's the first step, and the solution is to write 3 to the negative 2 in reciprocal form and change a negative exponent to a positive exponent. Okay, this is what you're going to do. Write 1 over 3 squared. Hey, they're talking again. Look! Again!
Talking about sailboats.
Sailboats, wow, that's a shocker. Yeah. Look at that hair. What's going on with your hair? No, no, you. You, Captain.
The lack of hair?
Yeah.
I was talking about
the bald spot on the top.
You can't put that in the video?
That's why he wears that hat.
I love you guys. I love everybody out there. This is the smolder.
We all lose our hair eventually.
Smolder. Blue steel.
Blue steel. You see Seth's growing a goatee, he's trying to be like me.
Oh, yeah.
You see that? He didn't have that yesterday. Now he's got the goatee. He's
doing my prison look.
He's trying to look like Keith. So, you guys don't get excited. He's not, he's a lightweight Keith is what he is.
Just like my boat.
Just like his boat. It's a lightweight something.
I'm the performance Keith.
Yeah.
I can jump higher.
He goes fast and he's really quick.
Here's the active version.
You get me, it's a marathon, baby. We go all night long. You know.
One day.
Una semana.
This one.
1 week.
Un mes.
What's this one?
Un año.
I just guessed that whole thing.
You got him right.
Yay!
Woo! Guessing works.
Tim Tam.
Tim Tam.
That's all I've eaten.
Tim Tams.
Gotcha.
The Tim of the Tam.
We are in Australia. We're in our quarantine hotel. We're on day like numbers 5 or 6. We've got 8 nights left and we get out of here. But right quick, we wanted to answer a few questions and talk about a few things and what our experience has been so far. The first question out of the box is coming from Mr. Brennan Carty. He asked, what do you do about visas, getting into countries, those kind of things like that? Brandon, that's a great question. Most countries we go to issue you upon arrival a temporary visa that can last anywhere from 30 days, 90 days, to 6 months to a year. You get that automatically as a tourist, and then when you leave, it's over. They stamp your passport, and that's what happens. In the time of COVID here, we had to apply for a visa, a real legitimate visa through immigration for Australia, and I had to do all kinds of health tests and stuff like that. In times of COVID, things are a lot different for sure. There's a lot more regulations and they want to know who's coming into their country and why. Basically, Australia, we are so thankful that you let us in. You gave us cyclone refuge here. We have safe havens. We're grateful to the people of Australia. And when you see the videos coming out, you'll see our experience. This is what we experienced. Fiji set up the Blue Lanes procedure, and they had it figured out from day one how they were going to do it. And so when you got into Fiji, they had a place where all the boats, one port, you could only go to one port in Fiji, and that's where all the boats had to go. And they created a quarantine zone there, an anchor area out in the middle of the bay there, and you had to be in that bay. And the minute you got there, the Navy came by, took your information down. They didn't come on your boat. They didn't expose you to them or them to you. And they said, okay, you got here on this day, you had so many days at sea, you will stay here. And by the way, guys, do y'all need any SIM cards? Do you need fruits and vegetables? Do you need food, water? What can we do for you? Bula Bula, we're glad you're here. Happy to see you here. Let us help you guys out and enjoy your quarantine. Let us know if there's anything that we can do for you. Very great, positive experience when we came into Fiji. And that was, you know, I was expecting probably a little of the same thing when we got to Australia. When we came into Australia, Australian Border Force was excellent. They were super nice, took care of our immigration paperwork. Unfortunately, in Australia, unlike Fiji, there's different states here. And so the states all have been tasked with enforcing quarantine of their own borders, which is the way it should be. States should have sovereignty and they should have the rights to enforce their borders as they will and their quarantine issues as they will. And so they have a lot going on here. They're a country of 20 million people. And so Queensland is where we chose to come in. And when we got here, we were expecting, according to all of our emails and correspondence and the things we got approved, we were expecting to come into Southport, go to the Q dock, clear immigration and customs, go through the health check, and then move our boat up to the marina where we had a berth, because Southport didn't have any berths available, even though it's a port of entry. They didn't have any berths available. And then move our boat and secure our boat at a marina while we were in quarantine for 14 days. And that's what we were under the understanding of, and that's what we thought would happen. The minute we get here, everybody's nice, but everybody says, once you clear, you got an hour to get off your boat, you're gonna leave it on anchor, and you gotta go find somebody to move it up to the marina where you have a berth. You know, we had to negotiate a few things, and we had to go through a few things to get the Queensland Police, Maritime, and they were very professional with us and very patient, although they were very frustrated because I was being very adamant about, I'm not leaving my boat on an anchor out here in this bay where currents are going back and forth, people are going back and forth, and we're at Q and I can't do nothing about it. That was frustrating for them that I wouldn't just capitulate and say, yeah, whatever. It was just a different expectation and a different experience here. Now, we're very grateful. The Queensland Police, Maritime Police, they were very patient. And they had to listen to me for 4 hours, and I feel sorry for them because, you know me, I'll go on a freedom rant, I'll go on all these things about what I think about, and they listened to me drag on and drone on for 4 and 5 hours, and we had great intellectual conversations about policies and procedures and governments, and I enjoyed it very much. I don't know if they enjoyed it as much as me, but we're thankful that they were patient and they worked the system. They had absolutely no power. The only power Queensland Police Force had was to follow the rules and follow the orders. It all rested with Queensland Health and the doctors at Queensland Health of what kind of risk we were. We spent 10 days at sea, totally quarantined. You could follow us on our tracker. That would prove, you know, our tracking page and our captain's log, but we didn't come in contact with anybody from the time we left Fiji. Once we got here, we were exposed to probably somewhere, by the time we got to the hotel, somewhere between 10 and 20 people had exposure to us and we had exposure to them. In Fiji, a difference, just a contrast, not saying it's better or worse, but in Fiji, we got to the quarantine, we sat on the hook, nobody touched us, we didn't touch anybody. Here, they haven't really worked through a great procedure yet for cruisers. They're just lumping us in with all the air traffic that comes in here, all the motor traffic that comes through here, and they're just treating everybody the same, even though their circumstances are not the same, and maybe there's a better way to skin the cat. But so far, because cruisers are such a minute, small part of the overall COVID problem, that it's really not worth looking at. So it's just coming from our perspective. We understand they got to treat everybody the same. It's a big country, a lot of moving parts. We don't have time to single out special procedures for this group or this group or this group or this group. We're just going to lump them all in. This is what we're going to do. And that was kind of frustrating. That's the bureaucracy of big governments, and that gets frustrating. And thank you guys for watching the show. I hope that explains a lot of things, and we're looking forward to our adventures around Australia. We're looking forward to going around South Australia, going around the bike, going to Western Australia. There's some great hiking places and fishing places out in Western Australia. We are at the Boat Works. That's where our boat is. We're gonna get a few jobs done there. Hopefully we're getting lithium batteries. Hopefully we're getting new engines in the boat. Just to let you know, Team Tuesday, they're gonna be filming our last few days in quarantine. It'll be on the Team Tuesday video, us leaving quarantine, getting out of the hotel and going back to the boat. So make sure you tune in and watch that. If you like what you're seeing, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, share it with your friends and family. Check us out on Instagram, Facebook, and I don't do much on Twitter. But check it all out. And once again, guys, I look forward to seeing you guys out there on the water.